Hey, this is DJ from djstrains on YouTube. I love modeling the steel industry and also rail fanning the prototype. In previous videos, I showed how steel is made, starting with coke. And then in a second video, I showed how iron ore is transported and how it's mixed in the blast furnaces. And then the addition of scrap and lime and the basic oxygen furnace and how it comes out into be steel slabs. Now in this video, we're going to look at some incredible footage of the steel slabs being transported, and then we'll look at some finished products, and then we'll take a close look at a scrap yard that you can model. Well, they say the third time is a charm, and it did take three tries before the Union Railroad was able to shove their slab train up the grade coming out of the Edgar Thompson Works. This shows how heavy steel slabs are. Now, the cars are especially made for handling steel slabs. The slabs will come out hot and are usually moved to the Irvin Works while they are still hot. You will actually see the word hot stenciled on these cars. Modeling steel slabs is fun, easy, and affordable because I did a video showing you how to do it with simple styrene, and I'll post a link in this video's description. Now, when the Union Railroad got onto their main line, they changed direction and are heading south to the Irvin Works, where the steel slabs will be heated, run through a series of rollers, and turned into steel coil. However, in just a few years, that process of going to the Irvin Works will probably be discontinued. As we see the track panels at Edgar Thompson, they are putting in some new track and new buildings, and they are going to go from the basic oxygen furnace and right into making coils in one process. And I got as close as I could to one of the new buildings where this process will take place. So we still have a little time to capture these slab trains, but things are moving quickly. Over $1 billion being spent to do this. So now we're looking at the Turtle Creek Railroad engine in McKeesport, and this is the Dorabond plant. And you're probably wondering, what does this have anything to do with what we were just talking about? Well, the Dorabond plant in McKeesport, formerly Camp Hill, formerly United States Steel National Works, is where the coils can go to be turned into pipe. Now, this used to be served by the Union Railroad in conjunction with the McKeesport Connecting Railroad. Now the coils are brought in by CSX, like me, and then Dorabond uses their plant to make pipe. Now they haven't got pipe loads out recently by rail. They've been shipping it out by truck. As we see here, there was a steady stream of flatbed trucks being loaded with the pipe. But this is something very easy to model. And there you can see some of the pipe that is unprotected and it is rusted. But a lot of the pipe that they make here is also coated and ready for shipment. The track work goes back about 100 years. Really doesn't meet the demand today, but I'm glad the track is still there in that capacity. And it is still very busy bringing the coils in, turning it into pipe, and then ship that on truck. Moving pipe by rail can be done with gondolas. And here's a great shot of three cars carrying pipe. Those pipes are banded together tightly and then secured again with wood bracing. I don't know why some of the ends are painted red. Maybe you can comment on that. But this will give you some great modeling ideas. SDI has three locations in the Pittsburgh area. We are looking at GalvTech, which is in the Hayes or Homestead area of Pittsburgh. Now, GalvTech is serviced by both CSX and the Allegheny Valley Railroad. We are looking at the side that is serviced by CSX, and I've serviced this place numerous times in my career. What we do is shove these covered coil gons with the cold rolled steel. We shove them up and straight into the door. Now the door is open here. The coils will be removed, dipped, and then returned back to the coil cars. Now GalvTech has their own switcher, and it's just a little switcher engine, and it's inside the plant right now. But whenever those cars are loaded and ready to go, they will use their engine and put the cars on the outbound track. And here we see a handful of cars that are waiting for CSX to pick them up. Occasionally, we will deliver them a boxcar with probably packaging material or bags of zinc or something. But usually, it's just the coil cars. Now, looking at the car by itself, that yellow tie isn't for clearance. It's just to let you know that it's a slight curve, and if you do not have that car behind that yellow tie, it is very hard to tie onto it with an engine. And I found that out the hard way when I was a conductor. So I thought it was also neat to show you how the tracks are embedded into the concrete. Also in the same town as GalvTech and off the same CSX spur is Keystone Scrap Iron and Metal. Now the scrap yard receives its scrap by truck, sorts it, and then sends it out by rail. Now when I see people model scrap yards, they seem to make everything rust colored. And let's look, not everything is rust colored. They're going to sort the aluminum from the steel and other metals because an electric arc furnace is going to use more of the aluminum, and the blast furnace will use that rusted steel that you're used to seeing. Now we deliver them between 1 to 2 empty gondolas. I'm going to say maybe once a week, maybe even longer than that. There was just a car here the day before I shot this. I guess CSX pulled it that night. This building looks pretty easy to scratch build. Just something simple for the workers. Let's see some of the other details. Now notice there is a chain link fence that is over the tracks. And that's why we can't get more than 1 to 2 cars in here. Now Keystone's a pretty big place, and they have the land on the other side of the tracks and on the other side of the Glenwood Bridge. But this is the only place that you will see rail service. Even though if you look closely, you'll see Norfolk Southern's main line in the background. But we're going to go up close and see this area. See some action with their blue crane. And here's a scene I was really excited to show you. It's not often you get to see a working scrapyard, especially from this angle. Now notice this isn't what you'd see on a lot of people's layouts, where it's just rust and brown colored trucks and old automobiles. I don't see anything really resembling a car here. In fact, most of the stuff is aluminum, and I even see some brighter colors. I didn't expect to see light blue and just, you know, more colorful than the traditional rust. So take a good look, and we'll watch him throw this piece over to here. That's pretty neat, huh? And even if you decide not to have your railroad service the scrapyard, just maybe have it next to the tracks. Like here we see Norfolk Southern's main line and a fast NS train passing Keystone Scrap Iron and Metal. I hope this video gave you some great ideas and some inspiration for adding some steel-related industries to your layout. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so under DJ's Trains, and you can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, and also check out my website, djstrains.com. If you want to support the channel, you can maybe buy some merchandise from the Teespring site or make a donation through my PayPal site. I have more videos coming because I've filmed a lot of stuff. So thank you so much, and I'll talk to you in the next video.